Hi there. Today we're going to be talking about how to make a really nice alphabet Rangoli, which I believe it's an Indian name for a really nice pattern that you can see in a lot of the Indian art. So this is a Rangoli pattern, which is like a diamond in the middle. And I believe the Indian people use it a lot in their artistic features, which is really cool. So you're given an integer n. Your task is to print an alphabet Rangoli of size n. Rangoli is a form of Indian folk art based on creation of patterns. Different sizes of alphabet Rangoli are shown below. So if the user tells you the size is 3, this is going to be your pattern. It starts from letter C, which is the third letter in the alphabet. Then you have CBC, then you have CBABC. So you can see what the pattern looks like. So size 3 means that you will have 9 characters up the top and you will have 5 rows. So 1, 2, 3, 2, 1 kind of thing. If you look at size 5, it is more evidence that we start from letter E. In the center, we have E, D, C, B, A, and then again, B, C, D, E, and that's the same pattern over the rows. And size 10 looks really cool to me, and we're hoping to build this one. So if you're a new viewer, welcome to my channel. If you're returning, welcome back. If you like my series, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. That really, really helps me to reach more people out there. And I really appreciate that. All right. So our code will have 2 sections. The top section is the recipe writing. Imagine you were making a butter chicken and you write, hey, this is how you make butter chicken. And the bottom part is actually when you press enter and you get to work and you make that butter chicken based on the recipe up there. So I really want you to remember that. For this challenge, I think you can imagine that we will need the alphabet. So let's make a new variable. So sorry, before I go ahead, I've got Jupyter Notebook here on the side, which will help me explain things a bit deeper before really going down deep in Hackerrank. So you can imagine that you need the alphabet. So one way would be just printing the alphabet, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. This is one way of getting your alphabet. And the other one, I'm just going to call it alphabet 2, would be to say, hey, give me a list and use the character function and get your character I for I in range, whatever range that you want, starting from 97, because letter A sits in character 97, and say 100. And we've got 26, so this one should be 23. So if I look at print alphabet, first one goes from ABCD all the way, and print alphabet, this is going to be a list one, but I don't care. I just want to make sure it runs from A to Z. So two ways, if you want to get the alphabet, you can do either way. But I personally prefer the second way, because with the first one, I will have to convert it to a list anyway. So I have to write another, say, make a list out of this. So you can do that. Now, if I look at alphabet 1 and alphabet 2, they're pretty much the same. So whichever feels right, you can do that. I'm just going to stick to the list comprehension and I'll get rid of alphabet 2, make it alphabet 1 because I like this. And okay, so I've got the alphabet sorted. That should be pretty easy. The other thing that will make my life easier will be to get the list of the indexes. So I will make a new variable called indices, and I will say, make me a list of the range of whatever the user gives me. So if the user gives me something called size, because that's what I can see here, I will make an index list of that size. So let's introduce size up here, and let's say the user gave me, if the user gave me 3, and if I made indices of that, I can see what it looks like. I can see that it runs from 0, 1, and 2. However, if you look at the pattern, you will see that we will go from the back to the front and from the front to the back again. So ideally, I would like to make a list that says 0, 1, 2, 1, 0, because I want to be able to make that pattern. Well, I think it should be very easy if I say, hey, why don't you go from indices all the way to the last one, which will be 01, not including the very last one. So once I have this one done, all I need to do is to add it to the same indices but in the opposite direction. So starting from the back to the front. What happens, I will get 0, 1, 2, and 1, 0. Brilliant. I think I will add this to indices itself so that I can store it. So let's just remember that we made indices here. I'm just doing some housekeeping. Okay. And then print indices so the viewers can see it. Brilliant. Now I have the indices ready. So why did I make my indices? I think you will appreciate once I run this for I in indices. Okay. I want you to start from index I plus one. And there is a reason for that. And then I want you to print the alphabet from minus start index onwards. So you can see that I'm getting from the very end of the alphabet because obviously I did not respect what size of alphabet I need. So to make that work, I need to say, hey, because the user has told me I want you to only use the first three, I will have to say, sorry guys, let's only take to what the user says. Let's go all the way to what the user said. And that will take me ABC. If I run that and I will run that, you will see that, okay, this is making sense now. So if you looked at the size three, you will see up the top, we have C and then we have B and C, and then we have A, B and C. But what I have is the right side of that Rangoli. I want to be able to make the left side. So I only have this right side here. All right, to make the left part of that, I need to make a new one. Say, let's make this one the original and get rid of the print function. So this was my original. And I will make the reverse of the original. So that will be original in the reverse order, which is this one. Now, if I say my new row will be reverse plus original, starting from one, and the reason it being is that I don't want to repeat the same thing twice, because look, if I get rid of this and print row, it looks great, but I'm repeating, for example, here, C, B, A, A, B, C. No, I don't want to repeat A twice here or B twice here, but I only need one of them. All I need to do, I'll need to say, I want you to take anything after the first index from the original so that I will get rid of that partition. So now you can easily see, okay, I'm making that pattern almost. So I've got C up here and I've got CBC, CBABC and so forth. So the only thing that would make me one biggest step closer to the pattern would be just to join them together and put hyphens in the middle. So if I set row equals, take this hyphen and join anything that is in this row, which is these guys, join them together using this hyphen. Look at that. You will see that, well, I am way, way closer to the pattern. I just need to put this C in the center and just put a hyphens around it, which is really, really easy. All you need to do now is to say the width of what I am making equals the size times 4 minus 3. So I'll leave you to understand why I did this. If you have any questions, put it down in the comments and I will explain it to you why I did it. So, but when I get that width, my new row will equal my older row, which are these guys. And I will use the center function to bring them to the center of the printing panel. And I will use the width that I calculated up there. And I will fill in the blanks with that hyphen. Easily, you will see that I was able to make the one with 3. So if I go with 10 this time, you will easily see that this alphabet Rangoli is looking really good. So how do I put it all together in my function? Well, I will need my bit of alphabet. So let's copy those bad boys. Put them down here. Okay, so that's my alphabet. The other thing I will need is the indices. So copy my indices here as well. Always remember that the second line needs to be tapped. So press the tab there. And I think with this one, all I need to do is just copy and paste it here. Again, everything needs to be tabbed. And let's run this code and see if it works. Hopefully it does, otherwise I have done something wrong. Okay, it did work for the sample test. If I submit it, all these cases, brilliant, they were very successful. And if you like this video, hit the like button. Feel free to throw any questions at me. I'm more than happy to help you out. And subscribe to my channel. I spend a lot of time preparing these videos, and that means a lot. Thank you.